The Google software engineer behind this controversial 10-page memo is out. Gone after blasting diversity and women in the workplace. A source at Google tells CNN that he is no longer listed in an online company directory. Multiple news outlets have just been flat out saying he's been fired. This guy argued that women are inherently less suited for tech jobs than men for a host of biological and psychological reasons. Then defends his comments as just a differing viewpoint counter to progressive news. Now, according to Bloomberg News, he is now, quote, exploring all legal remedies. So let's bring in two ladies to discuss this. Liz Plank, senior correspondent and producer for Vox.com, and Mary Catherine Hamm, CNN political commentator and senior writer for The Federalist and author of End of Discussion. So, all right. MK, beginning with you. You say, you're taking the contrarian view. You say the outrage has gone too far. So does that mean that you don't think he should have been fired?
Yeah, I actually quibble a bit with the characterization of this piece of writing that I don't think was either anti-diversity or a screed. That doesn't mean I agree with all of it. There were some eye-rolling parts of it, but I think he invokes biology and the parts that I did not love in an effort to say, look, we should examine our industry and what in aggregate genders are motivated by and what they are not and how that might be a factor in some of the gender inequality we have in this industry. That is not the same as saying women are unfit for tech jobs. And it was sort of like mounted in this rather mild and dispassionate way. And here is my concern.
Yeah.
As you may have noticed, I enjoy disagreeing with people. I relish people who disagree with me. I like living with them. I like being friends with them. I even married one of them. And I think it is what makes American life rich. And I think that when we get to the point where something that is a rather mild and dispassionate disagreement within an organization, which by the way offered a forum for having such disagreements, rises to this level of a national story and economic disadvantage for the person who presented this argument, then we are not a society that is celebrating free speech or that has discussions that get to actual issues and solve problems. And the part of the reaction to this has been people, mainstream folks writing in mainstream publications, verified Twitter accounts saying they would like to beat the bleep out of this person for saying it, that we should round up all the people who agree with him and fire them also. Okay. And those are totalitarian impulses, and I'm not on board with that.
Okay. Whew. All right. So that's where you are, and I appreciate that viewpoint. Liz, where are you on all of this? You agree with her or disagree?
Right. I mean, this employee was an at-will employee. Google can choose to fire them as they please. I think you can respect that. It is important in American society that we respect employers' decisions to do that. And look, what this manifesto did and the conversation that that sort of ensued is important one. And the disagreement, I think, is great and why I'm so happy that, Brooke, you've been talking about this issue and really bringing light to it. And for Google, this has been bad. I mean, it drew attention to the fact that Google has a serious problem with diversity. I find it really ironic that a search engine company that can help me find a pizza has so much trouble finding women and people of color to fill their positions. If you look at the data, which, Brooke, I think you talked about yesterday on your show, 7 out of 10 employees at Google are men. That is not representative of society.
69%.
Only 2% of their employees are African Americans. And if you look at other cities like Washington, 17% of high-tech workers are African Americans. And so there's really a problem, and people say it's a pipeline issue.
Do you agree, like, you know, Mary Catherine, I think it was essentially saying, you know, America's great for all these various opinions, diversification of thought, you know, that was maybe wrong for Google, despite the fact that maybe we don't all agree with what this guy said, he's allowed to say it. Do you think he was allowed to say that, where he's essentially saying, well, I don't really like women anywhere near a computer, and should he have been fired for it? Liz?
I find it interesting that he felt comfortable sharing this with people at the company in the way that I felt that it was interesting, you know, when stuff came out of the culture at Uber that was, you know, enabled systemic sexual harassment and the sort of things that I think a lot of men felt like they could say and do were not appropriate. I do wonder what kind of culture exists at Google that made a white man who's in a senior position, engineer at one of the biggest tech companies in the world, feel threatened by a few diversity programs, and then share that with and write 10 pages about it, and you know, fear it and it have leaked in the way that it had, and think that there'd be no consequences.
But isn't a piece of this, Mary Catherine, this is directed to you, where this software engineer, you know, he had hiring power. I mean, he could impact the empowerment of women. And again, I go back to, you know, paraphrasing, this is a guy who's basically saying, I don't like women around computers, you know, whether it's peer reviews.
I actually, Brooke, and I often disagree with you in like very jovial way, and I just totally disagree with the characterization that's what he's saying.
Yeah.
He wasn't saying, and that's why I disagree with the reaction to this. If it were what you were saying, I would be more on board with Liz's point of view. But look, I think we're saying, look, this is a valuable conversation to have, and I agree. One of the things that this person was bringing to the table was that perhaps part of diversity is ideological diversity as well. And ironically, and no one seems to recognize the blinding irony of this, he was saying one of the problems with Google is that we are perhaps in this like ideologically insular bubble that is so insular that people like me feel silenced and don't want to bring our opinions to the forefront. And then wait a second. In response to that, his dissenting opinion, it was leaked to punish him, and then he was fired for it having been leaked.
So I mean, how should Google have handled that? I have 1 minute left, and I wish I had more, but how should Google then, Mary Catherine, have handled it instead of saying, we don't agree, you're out?
Look, my approach to all of these things is that more speech is better, and that when you get to the point where you are essentially saying you will be economically punished for something that's not really, really out of bounds, which I don't think this memo was, then we are not having a discussion and we're not celebrating free speech. And that doesn't mean government's cutting down on it, but I think there are ways that we can encourage it that are really important.
20 seconds.
And they could have said,
you get the last word.
We're going to have a disagreement.
I love it. I dig it.
I'm all for speech, but I'm not for, and it's not even that the manifesto was offensive. It wasn't true. He didn't do his research.
That's fine. You don't get
computer
fired for
engineering was used to be a female-dominated field in the 40s. Everyone can go Google it. And women were pushed out of that field, and their and silence and their contributions to the field were erased. There's a whole movie about that. Go see Hidden Figures. And I encourage everyone to do their research.
I appreciate both your voices. Thank you so much. Mary Catherine Hamm, Liz Plank, appreciate you. I'm Brooke Baldwin. Gotta go. The lead starts now.